Hi, it's Nikki here from Happy Hormones for Life, and today I'm going to be talking to you about endocrine disrupting chemicals and some ways that we can avoid them. So what do you know about them? What do you know about these endocrine disrupting chemicals? Well, I didn't know anything before I started studying hormones. I know they are like our invisible hormone wreckers all around us. So you may be doing all the right things to balance your hormones. You may be eating a nutrient-dense diet, exercising, managing your stress, all the things I talk about, and maybe you're still having symptoms because you might be missing this crucial piece of the hormone balancing jigsaw, these endocrine disrupting chemicals. So what are they? They are a group of recognized chemicals that are known to interfere with endocrine function. So endocrine meaning hormone in some way. That means that they can disrupt your normal hormone balance by imitating your hormones or interfering with their signaling. In particular, we're talking about estrogen. These chemicals can act like fake estrogens. So they're similar to our own estrogens. So they can land on our estrogen receptors and imitate our own estrogen. And that can really disrupt the normal signaling and functioning of our cells and our hormones. And this is known to increase, to contribute to increasing number of health issues such as the viability of sperm, ovarian dysfunction, neurodevelopmental deficits, and of course obesity and other health issues as well. And of course it's going to make your menopause journey a much tougher one if you've got these going on. So where are these chemicals kind of lurking? Pretty much everywhere. And when you can't see them, it's not easy to know about them. So they're in the air we breathe, the food we eat, the water we drink, our household products that we use in the home, and our beauty and personal products that we either inhale or we put on our skin. So things like perfume, body lotion, cosmetics, shower gels, all sorts. So what are the big ones to avoid? Because we can't avoid them all. That would mean locking ourselves away and putting a gas mask on. The big ones to avoid are BPA. We know about this one, right? It's one of the most researched endocrine disrupting chemicals. It's in plastic. Plastic everything, from water bottles to food containers to till receipts to tin can linings. BPA has been linked to everything from breast and reproductive issues, obesity, early puberty, and heart disease. So best to avoid that one. Pesticides is the next section. So when something's invented to kill living insects, you know it's not going to be very good for us either. So despite many studies linking organophosphate pesticide exposure to numerous health issues, they are still the most common pesticides in use today. And a few ways that these can affect your hormones include interfering with testosterone signaling and changing your thyroid hormones as well. The next group of EDCs are phthalates, spelled P-H-T-H, hard to say, very hard to spell, but this group of chemicals are found in everything that smells nice, basically synthetic fragrances, as well as some plastic products as well. Now, studies have linked phthalates to hormone changes, infertility, birth defects, obesity, diabetes, and thyroid issues, amongst other things. Phthalates are to be avoided if possible. Of course, they're in everything, so it's hard to avoid, but I'll come on to that in a minute. The next one is perfluorinated chemicals, PFCs. These are things that are made to make things non-stick. But the trouble is they stick to your insides too. They're very hard to degrade. They can stay in your body for a long time. And again, lots of health issues associated with those. And then the last sort of big section of EDCs are heavy metals, so lead, mercury, arsenic, of course, have been linked to hormone disruption amongst other things. So lead found in some paint, lipstick, tap water, things like that, arsenic, some rice products, also in water potentially, and then mercury, obviously fillings and large fish. So I'm going to cover 7 ways to minimize exposure, because this is all very depressing, but there's huge amounts we can do. We're not going to be able to get rid of our exposure to everything because it's all around us, but we can really minimize our exposure by doing these 7 things. First thing to do is to reduce plastic. So we want to minimize the use of plastic water bottles, food containers, plastic wrap, tins, can linings. Go for the ones that are non-BPA, usually the organic ones possibly, but there are other brands as well. What we want to most avoid is BPA leaching into our food and drink, particularly when it's heated. So don't put plastic in the oven or the microwave. Don't leave your water bottle in a hot car and then drink the water. because that's when the BPA can leach in, when it's heated or warmed up. So if you can swap to glass or stainless steel, you're obviously going to help the planet as well. But if not, please just avoid heating your plastic. Number two is to eat organic where possible. Not everything, but obviously it's not always possible to eat everything organic or, you know, even affordable. But where you're eating the skins of things like salad leaves or fruit, it's best to try and get those organic, and then you're just going to avoid ingesting too many pesticides. Number three is to filter your water. Water can be contaminated with heavy metals, so best to get, you know, just a water filter. You can get it in your tap or in your fridge or whatever, or a water filter bottle. They're really easily available now. Number four is the candles and the air fresheners. Oh, goodness me, this is probably not the most popular one I talk about. Inhaling these phthalates in the synthetic fragrances, those lovely smells that come off your scented candles, your air fresheners, is the quickest way to get these chemicals into your bloodstream, unfortunately. So, you know, when you eat something, you've got the gut and the liver to filter out the toxins. Inhaling, lungs, get into the lungs, straight into the bloodstream from there. So we want to be really careful about scented candles, air fresheners, and products with these smells. So when you get that lovely smell of something that us women, we love, you know, perfumes as well, right in there as well. And when we inhale that, that's when these phthalates can get in. So lots of alternatives on the market now. You can have diffusers with natural oils. You can use natural candles made with essential oils. Lots of different alternatives. So you don't have to rely on these, the standard kind of mainstream scented candles and air fresheners. Number five is to switch your cleaning and laundry products to brands that don't use phthalates in them. At the moment, I think Method is the one in the UK that says on the website they don't use phthalates in their cleaning products. Laundry products, things like Bio-D and Green Sense and lots of other ones. Ecova is the kind of middle ground, I think. But want to be avoiding those big brands because they use a ton of cleaning of chemicals and phthalates in there. Number six is just to switch to more natural personal products. So lovely brands out there now for your skincare, cosmetics, personal products. Tropic is one of my favorites. There's lots of natural deodorant companies now. Schmitz is one I quite like. You've got Neil's Yard, you've got Green People. Green People do an amazing natural mascara, by the way. Weleda, Dr. Bronner's, I love their organic body lotions. Burt's Bees, I use my lip seals, really nice. Dr. Hauschka does lovely cleansers and skincare as well. There are plenty out there now, way more than there ever used to be. BigGreenSmile.com is one of my favourite websites for all kind of natural brands. And of course, there's the app, the Think Dirty app. It's not what it says. It's an app where you can check your favourite product for how toxic it is. And that's a bit of an eye opener if you use that. And then lastly, replacing your non-stick cookware. So the Teflon-y type stuff is full of these nasty chemicals. So if you can, next time you want to buy a new pan, you either go with ceramic or stainless steel or the more ecological pan brands, and then use more oil, olive oil or coconut oil to prevent sticking. This is a really good way of just avoiding that. So doing more of this stuff will definitely help reduce your exposure to these chemicals, but also you want to be supporting your liver as well to help you detoxify the ones you can't avoid. But it's really important not to get overwhelmed by any of this. It's taken me, God, almost 15 years to kind of clean up my cupboards and replace things bit by bit. So you don't need to do it all at once, absolutely. It's just swapping out one product at a time when you run out. If you want to just start to minimise your exposure. Hope that's been helpful. Do contact us if you'd like more help with your health or your hormones. We're always here. I'll see you soon.